There is a quite a difficult question for you, Nolwenn. It's a question from Pierre Lebas-Banchon. So, what is the impact of the global change on biofuel prediction and, of course, for the optimal offshore structure design?
Ah, you're right, Catherine. That's a difficult one. I'm
not sure we to answer to this one.
I'm not sure. I think we are not able to predict what changes will occur, but at least there are some things that we know, some changes that will probably happen with the climate change. I'm thinking particularly of changes in species composition, for example, with species from the south that will appear in northern areas, while species that are currently living, for example, in Atlantic, that will go up north. So there will be probably some changes there. And we also know that with the increase in seawater temperature, the reproduction of some species can be stimulated. So maybe there will be some changes also there. But say, what kind of biofueling will develop under this changed condition is quite tricky. But regarding the designs, that's also something that is difficult to say, because yeah, we have no idea of the influence on the thickness, for example, or the biomass that will occur probably with changes in seawater temperature.
Thank you. Which one? Françoise from Naval Energy has a good question, and I think Guillaume wants to answer to this
No.
I think. Could you assess the impact of catodic protection on marine growth? Well. No idea. So we will ask to some other expert, I think.
Yeah.
I have a question for Fabien from the Bureau Veritas at the beginning. The question was from Lucie, I think, Le Pissier. Is Bureau Veritas not doing marine growth weight calculation? So,
yes. Well, not sure I clearly understand the question. Of course, we take into account the weight of marine growth for our for all our independent analysis. And if the question is, is Bureau Veritas performing a specific assessment of marine growth weight? I don't think so. But I can double check that with some of my colleagues. But I don't think so.
Thank you, Fabien. We are looking for. For the question. I have the there is another question. It was from Emmanuel Law. No. What was the question about cleaning process? Yes,
yeah.
From Thibaut Capet. And I think you have the same question. I have the same question. What is the difference between mechanical cleaning and polymeric blade? And I think that was a question for Fabien.
Yes.
Again.
Yeah. Well, Thibaut is correct. The polymeric blade can also be considered as a mechanical cleaning. What I called mechanical cleaning is in my presentation was the different sorts of brushes that were used for marine growth cleaning. But yeah, I have to admit the wording I used was maybe not the most adapted because both brushes and the polymeric blades are two different types of mechanical cleaning. Indeed.
Thank you. A question for Guillaume from Christine, your colleague. So simulation were one from RE 0 to 5, 10,005.
Yeah.
What are the Reynolds number measured on site?
Okay, Christine. If I well understand your question, the question is, do the basin test? What is the scale of the basin test, perhaps? Because yes, typically it depends of the size of the component, but for the dynamic cable, which we are focused on dynamic cable on this basin test, we were at scale one. So we have a look on realistic Reynolds number, but for the oscillating flow, we are limited by the actuator in the basin for sure. And that's the reason why our KC number are a bit low. These are realistic KC number, but we are limited to more fatigue range than extreme. Because we choose to be at scale one because we suspected, and this is confirmed, that the local flow, so the flow which is impacted by the surface roughness, is very impacted, and the viscous aspect of the flow is very important, and therefore the only way to respect Reynolds similitude is to be at scale one. So at site we can have some higher KC number in an extreme event, in a storm typically, but the range, the cover range, are typical of day-to-day conditions. So for fatigue, it's a good first insight. I don't know if it's okay regarding your question, Christine.
She's fine with your answer.
Okay, thank you. But we can discuss a bit further. No problem.
There is another question. I'm not sure to understand the question. So which model is used for modeling? And I think this is for Arthur. What is the effect induced by nylon?
I guess it's referring to the configuration I showed without and with marine growth in both extreme and fatigue analysis. We are using both configuration. Either we are performing, for example, for a mooring analysis, it's usually more critical to consider marine growth on it, so we consider it mainly with it, but we always at least perform a sensitivity with a model that present no marine growth on it to be sure that we won't have any trouble during the life of the project. So both models are used for modeling. And in terms of the offset, in our case, offset is about maximum offset in 50 years return period storm are about 70 meters, so almost, let's say, twice the water depth. So this is why we have quite a large lazy way for the dynamic cable, especially.
Thank you, Arthur. So there is another question from Pierre to Nolwenn, and I think the answer is yes. Have you used MNONET database for your study?
We have been consulted the MNONET database, but we have not used the data gathered on this database. That's a long time ago, actually, since I've been looking at this database. But to my knowledge, there is no data on colonization itself. It's more on habitats, so more on the communities living in the sediments or on rocky shores. But yeah, I will check.
Another question, because we are talking about biocolonization, but we are not talking about the danger of invasive species. I mean, for the transport.
Mm.
Yes. Do you know if this problem is taking account?
Yeah. Invasive species are taken into consideration into environmental impact studies conducted by the developers and in the studies regarding biofueling is also taken into consideration. That's why measuring diversity while looking at biofueling is essential because this way you can gather data on potential invasion by AIS.
I have a question for Guillaume.
Ah.
I'm really interested by the project Ondine 2. So you have used one layer of muscle. Did you try several layers of muscle?
Not yet. I think yes. This is typically we start with basic assumption because there is a lot of things interesting things to do. But you're right. This is typically something we want to do in the second phase, among other possibilities. For example, to have a look on heterogeneity, but in a reduced point of view, not along the line. And also, yes, you're right. But also on the bubbles, because perhaps I didn't mention, didn't insist on that. Sorry, but we tried to have a look on the bulbous phenomena, which is observed very often. Why this is something interesting? Because some person mentioned the fact that there is some competitivity which can provide these bubbles phenomena. But we are thinking that it could be also an hydrodynamic effect. So we are not sure, but for sure there is some in the nature. And in a term of hydrodynamics, it may influence locally and globally also. So there are a lot of things to have a look on. But with your question, two layers, there is this a bit this issue on how can we define a single but representative value of diameter increase, roughness height. In the book, it's very simple, but in the reality, it's a very, very important issue. Now we know that on drag, there is an impact. So we will want to be more accurate on that, to take it into account in the engineering phase. But we clearly have to work on how to define representative and relevance value. And two layers, for example, or several layers, it's something we have to look at. Mm-hmm. But at which level we stop the flow, at which level we impact the flow, and what are the relevant values? This is really an issue, and I think we have a lot of tests to perform before reaching a good definition.
Yes. Do you have an equation, Luan and Guillaume?
I think it's okay, and now we are at the end of our.
I think we are, yes. Someone told me so that we are at the end of the session, and we have unfortunately to close this session. So thank you to all of us for following us, and also for the speakers.